Guys, I wasn't even going to make a video about this. I basically had this tube buffer for a couple of years now, and it's been floating around. It's been in a few projects. I didn't want to get the tube smashed or whatever. They've been sitting underneath the workbench for about a year or more. I started playing around with my Techniques. What was that model number I'm missing again? The SA-GX 690. And I found out where the preamp goes from the preamp to the main amp on the board. It's actually labeled, it says main in, and then there's two traces, steel traces, that one says L and the other says R, obviously for left and right. And beside that, there's a trace that says A ground. I'm guessing that's amp ground. So what I did is I cut the left and right and separated the preamp from the main amp, which will actually works pretty good if you wanted to put like four RCAs on the back and use it as a block amp, or use the preamp out for an external amp. But anyway, what I did is I ended up installing this tube buffer in between the preamp and the main amp. And I'm kind of blown away by the results, actually. I was just screwing around, and I just basically just set it up loosely in here and fired it up, and it's dead silent. But there's more gain on the preamp side. It's not distorted or anything, but it just makes this old receiver punchy, really punchy, actually. I'll probably be able to tailor it by changing up to the tubes. They're the old China-made tubes. I could try some different brands. But this buffer here is not those cheap ones that run on 24-volt plates. This one here has a 6-volt filament and it's 100 volts out for the plates. And it runs through a rectifier, so it's maybe 110, 115 volts. But it does sound really good. And what I did is I wired this transformer up to the back of the other one. And still runs through the same fuse, both of them. And the soft start initializes both of them. So it's totally safe there and protected. I used a little bit of shoe goo. Once I ran into this and I'm like, whoa, I gotta leave it the way it is, because it does sound really good. The standoffs, I made sure they weren't shorting the back of the board, and then I put shoe goo on the standoffs to glue it in so it doesn't move around. I can't say enough about this stuff. It smells really bad when it's drying, but one nice thing about it is if I ever have to repair the board and I got to get this out of the way, I can just literally pull the glue away, and it doesn't leave a residue or anything, and it's rubbery. So same thing with this transformer here. It's solid. It's not going to come loose. The whole thing shakes. If I wanted to break it away, I could just stick a piece of putty knife in there and pop it off. But, well, it's still not dry yet. Push my luck. But, yeah, it does sound pretty good. Power it up. Takes a second for it to warm up, like a tube amp would, but it's dead silent. And I found the imaging a little bit better. I don't know if it's because it's going through the circuit of the tubes or what, but it's more 3D sounding, if that makes any sense. It just sounds better. If you were to buy one of these and have it on the outside with the on the input, and then you had like you going through a CD player or a tape deck, it wouldn't be the same. But when you put it on an amplifier or a receiver that has the preamp out and main in, if you can do from the back, you'll see the difference. There's a major difference. If you got one of these floating around, I highly recommend you tap into the board and start playing around with one of these. This one's pretty old. I've had this one for a while. We'll try to get the name off of it. It says Gwanso or something like that. I've made another video on this preamp before. I had another amplifier that died a while back. That's why I was sitting on my bench. What I'll do is I'll link it to the video that I originally made it in, and you'll be able to find this. Hopefully they still make them, but most of them now are 24 volts. And I'm sorry, if a plate's running at 24 volts, it's not a legitimate tube. It's got at least 100 volts or more to be a legitimate tube. So, I'm kind of blown away. I'm getting a little bit excited about how well it sounds. It's brought new life to this old receiver. I'm not too sure how it would work on the surround mode, but that's the left and right is going through the tubes. The surround's still just separate from the rest. And I don't even know what traces are for the surround, but I know that trace there, where it says main in, that's definitely where you separate the preamp from the left and right amplifier. So I figured I'd share that. It's pretty cool. I'm just waiting for the glue to finish setting, and I can put the lid on. The transformer just clears the lid, but I couldn't really find another place to put it, so. Yeah, it works. Whatever works, right? Later, guys.